I understand Philip is upset, but he has his friends, his family.
Mother, I told you I can't leave, not now.
All right. Anyway, you look wonderful.
I feel wonderful.
And I just hope...
What?
Never mind, we'll talk when we get home.
Fine. Where are you staying?
Ed and Maureen have given me their guest room. They've been really kind.
Yeah, to me too.
Mm-hmm. But I'll get a suite somewhere or something, and we'll just hole up and talk for days and days.
Mother, I don't know if I can do that.
Maybe I could make an appointment. Oh, I'm sorry I said that.
Mother, I want to talk to you. It's just, I'm really worried about Philip. I don't know what's going on with Alan.
I know, Ed. No, I shouldn't have said that. It's just this place. Springfield. Not exactly thrilled to be back here.
I understand. You really didn't have to come here.
I didn't?
No, I'm fine.
Of course. You know, I just get a little nervous, you know, staying at Ed's house. And too many ghosts, I guess.
Or maybe just one.
Or just one. Your hair.
Oh, Mother, don't.
No, don't get defensive. I'll get used to it. I always do. Well? Well, shall we join the party?
Yes. Hi. Are you okay?
Yeah, I'm fine. Oh, Michael, can I talk to you for a minute? Yeah, why not?
I just got off the phone with Venezuela. Now, Aunt Alex is coming in tomorrow morning on the Spalding jet.
Yeah, I know that.
Well, no, look, Dad is coming in, too. Your Uncle Ed is bringing him in on a special medevac plane. Now, that's like a flying hospital, okay?
So thanks, Philip. I know all this, okay?
I'm just trying to tell you, he's in good hands. And if anything happens, Ed will know what to do. I don't think it's that serious, because if it were, Ed would not even allow him to fly.
See, I think so, too. I don't think it's that serious.
Yeah, all right, listen. I'm going to have to go tell Joseph to pick up Aunt Alex tomorrow at the airport, all right?
Look, hey... Are you okay?
Yeah, I'm fine.
Is there anything that I can do?
No. Look, just have a good time. I'm gonna take care of this, all right?
He's really upset.
I know. Just stay with him, would you?
Well,
do that for me.
Well. Frank!
Yeah, you must be sad to see this year end.
What did I do? Am I getting paid back for something?
What do you say, you and I sit down and have a talk about the meaning of life or something? Couldn't hurt.
So I thought maybe we could all get together and have lunch sometimes. I'd like to get to know Blake's friends.
I guess that would be lovely.
Excuse me, Holly. Sure. I wanted to show you a really wonderful painting that Alexandra has over here. It's really fabulous.
Well, thank God for Maureen.
What?
I asked her to give us a few moments alone. Tell me. Tell me, please, that you did not say anything to Philip about it.
No, I didn't say anything.
Thank you. Thank you.
Don't thank me because I don't think it's right.
Oh, please, don't say that.
This is Philip's baby, too. How can you keep that from him?
How? I will never forget that you were the one to tell me to lie. Through my teeth. Not just for Rick's or the baby's sake, but for...
Yes, Henry, the entire Spalding board, as soon as I land. Because Austin Aeronautics is ripe for the picking, and we need a victory badly. Oh, don't worry. I have the financing. It's a little cocoa deal I've been working on. Yeah, well, you tell Mr. Taggart he better not mess with me. I'm in no mood. Yes, Happy New Year to you too, Henry.
Sonny.
What?
Well, I'm getting pretty good at being able to read your moods now, and you're thinking about Sonny, aren't you?
She had no right.
To shoot Alan and tell him about the operation?
I wasn't keeping anything from him. I was trying to protect him.
I wonder if you'll ever be able to see it that way now.
No. It will always seem like I was lying to him.
You know, somehow it doesn't seem right. After all you've done for her.
She will find out what it means to betray me.
Especially since you stuck by her through thick and thin like you did, you know. Introducing her to Spaulding and Springfield society.
Well, if she thinks she can mess with the Spauldings.
Swapping recipes, supplying alibis.
She has another thing coming.
So you did. You are the one who gave her the alibi the night that Will Jeffries took his midnight swim.
I didn't say that.
Come on, why cover up for her now when she's obviously prepared to drop you like a bad habit?
Don't be journalistic. It's tedious.
Do you know that you always get imperious whenever you want to change the subject? What about the tape?
What tape?
Tape. The tape. The mysterious tape that was delivered the morning I was at your house. The tape, the one I delivered to Josh for you. It's all about Sonny, isn't it?
That wasn't what I wanted to change the subject to.
You know, Alexandra, you are far too intelligent to have been conned by even something as complicated as this. You've been on to Carrera for a while, haven't you?
I've had my doubts about her, yes. I have thought she may not be what she purports to be.
So you two think that Sonny is Solita.
Get your feet off there. This is not a newsroom.
There you go, being imperious again, trying to change the subject. So predictable.
Oh, don't ever say that to me. What time is it?
Almost time. Should old acquaintance be forgot?
Yes, yes, yes. I cannot wait to bid 1988 good riddance.
Do you know, we have almost everything here we could want. We got the timepiece, got the champagne, all the ingredients for a perfect New Year's, except for one thing.
What, funny hats?
Someone to kiss at midnight.
What am I, chop liver?
Mm-mm. But far be it from me as a confirmed member of the hoi polloi to rear up and steal a kiss from royalty. It has to be your own idea first.
Well, I would, but I'm afraid you'd turn back into a frog.
Are you okay?
No.
I keep thinking about how angry he is with me now when he needs me so much.
He'll get over it.
Let him be all right. Please let him be all right.
Ed is with him. Everything's gonna be aces.
I really think you should consider my offer. Have you forgotten what your family's done to you, Alan?
Not one of them has shot me yet.
Alan, that was a mistake.
Oh, I see. It was an accident, so I should forgive her.
Look, let's cut to the chase, Alan. Do you want to go back to Springfield now? You think you'll be operating from a position of power laid up in a hospital bed, do you?
That's nonsense. You and Sonny are responsible for this whole escapade. I was taken in like everyone else. Just another one of your victims.
Well, don't take it so hard.
It's not difficult. It's not hard for a sane man. You know, we're not all taken in by the thrall of Solita like you are. I admit she has some winning ways, especially in the prone position, but I've never been a fool for love. So you can just tell her, adios. It was great fun, but it was just one of those things, you know. Wouldn't you agree that in a situation like this, a man should stick with his family?
I think you just made a big mistake.